You've got mail.
The other day, I got a message from Denisee from Guatemala, and she said that she uses the word address at work a lot. But she doesn't know if she's pronouncing it correctly because sometimes her customers ask her to repeat herself. And then she ran into a little English-Spanish autocorrect problem, and she said algo, I think she meant also, is the word pronounced differently when asking a question or confirming. And she finishes by saying, this will help me a lot. Thanks for your help. Well, Denisee, thank you so much for your message. Thanks for your participation. I hope this explanation helps. Now, this is a tremendous question, and there are a few things that we need to look at here. And let's start with the definitions so that we're clear. And you'll see right away that there are two different pronunciations for this word, and that's because it can be both a noun and a verb. And depending on the part of speech, the pronunciation will change. And just focusing on the meanings, as a noun, this is the specific place where someone lives or a business is located. And this is what Denise is asking about. She's asking about the pronunciation of the noun. The verb, on the other hand, is similar, but just indicates the action of writing the name or address of a recipient on an envelope, a letter, or package, or just something that you are sending to someone or someplace. Now, in regard to the pronunciation, when we use the noun, we want to put the stress on the first syllable, and we use the a sound, as in apple. A-dress, address, address. So, for the sake of pronunciation, don't worry about that first D, and just focus on putting the stress on the a sound. Address. And then with the verb, we switch the stress to the second syllable and use the schwa sound. A-dress. Address. Address. So in Denise's case, when using the noun, she might say, what's your address? Or, let me just confirm your address real quick, is it? And when using the verb, who should I address this to? I mean, I guess technically you should say, to whom should I address this? But in my opinion, there's no problem with ending a sentence with a preposition. So I would say, who should I address this to? And if you Google noun-verb difference in pronunciation, you'll see that there are many other words that are both a noun and a verb and follow the same pronunciation pattern. With the noun, you'll stress the first syllable, and with the verb, you'll put the stress on the second. For example, an object is a material that can be seen or touched, like a thing. A basketball is a round object. But to object is to say something to express one's disapproval. Citizens object to the increase in taxes. So we have object, object. And let's look at another one. A permit is an official document giving someone the authorization to do something. You need a permit to park your car on my street. But the verb permit is to give authorization or consent to someone to do something. Schools often do not permit the use of cell phones in class. So you could even say, the permit permits. Okay, so why might this be confusing? Well, first, just like what we've been talking about, you have to understand and know that sometimes there is a difference in pronunciation between nouns and verbs, and that can be quite confusing and frustrating. Another confusing thing is that native speakers, depending on the word, they might use the two different pronunciations interchangeably. I have heard many native speakers say, what's your address? Or, what's your address? Now, this is only the case for a few of these words. Most of the time, it will sound very strange if you confuse the stressed syllable. For example, if you said, I need a permit to enter the building, that sounds very weird. It's, I need a permit. Or if you said, the citizens object to the increase in taxes. That sounds super strange. The citizens object. So just understand that sometimes you might hear a native use the incorrect pronunciation and get away with it, but most of the time, it would sound very, very strange. Also, in regard to the definitions, words can have many different definitions. So if you look at the original word, you'll see that the noun address is also a formal speech. And the verb to address also means to give a formal speech. So the fact that there are numerous meanings might also add to the confusion. All right, so let's recap. Denise is from Guatemala, and she had an awesome question. Address is a noun. Address is a verb. There are many words that can be both nouns and verbs, and sometimes they have different pronunciation. With the noun, the stress is on the first syllable. With the verb, the stress is on the second. There is no difference in pronunciation when asking a question or confirming with these words. Native speakers often don't know the rules of their own language, and words have numerous meanings. Thank you again for the question, Denise. Let me know if this helped. And also, if anybody else has a question, please feel free to ask.